Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to beautiful downtown Dardanelle and the scenic Canfield home field advantage to your Dardanelle Sand Lizards. Tonight, we would like to pay honor to our Dardanelle Sand Lizards 2016 4A Soccer State Champions. The Lizards finished the season with a 19-win, 1-loss, 3-tie record and culminated with a state championship. They also hold back-to-back conference titles and currently have a streak of 22 straight conference victories, making them the winningest team in Dardanelle soccer history. The team at this time would like to thank each and everyone involved in donating and helping with fundraisers to raise money for the state championship rings. They especially would like to thank the representative group on the field tonight, the goalie sponsors, for their generous donations. And the goalie sponsors are as follows: the Dardanelle Basketball Booster Club, Dardanelle Nursing and Rehabilitation Center, Chambers Bank, Rivertown Bank, Wood Chips and More, REC Transport and Custom Wood Products, the Dardanelle School District, Mr. Raymond Hartman, Flotec owner Kurt Spears, Farm Bureau Insurance Agency Josh Buchanan, the Perfecto family, Augustine Martinez, Mr. Donald Ernest Sr., and Centennial Bank. And now presenting your Soccer Sand Lizards with their state championship rings will be Coach Don Ernest and Coach Anthony Ross. Your state championship Sand Lizards. Number 0, JoJo Dominguez. Number 1, Jose Semeningo. Number 2, Justin Diaz. Number 3, Eduardo Mendoza. Number 5, Jason Cantor. Number 6, Roberto Martinez. Number 7, Aiden Morales. Number 9, Chris Cavallaro. Number 11, David Rodriguez. Number 12, Marvin Hernandez. Number 13, Edgar Perfecto. Number 14, Timo Martinez. Number 15, Wesley Robinson. Number 16, Eduardo Perfecto. Number 17, Christian Asaves. Number 18, Pablo Carrion. Number 19, Jacinto Diaz. Number 20, Hunter Jackson. Number 21, Ali Ramirez. Number 24, Jose Perez. Number 30, Gonzalo Pena Jr. Number 35, David Perez. Number 36, Reese Tenango. Who, by the way, San Leonard fans, happened to be your only senior. So good things coming for this bunch. Unable to attend tonight with number 8, Nervin Martinez, and number 10, Luis Villegas. Once again, Coach Brian Hardaway, Coach Don Ernest, and Coach Anthony Ross. Thank you so much for your efforts with these young men. We do appreciate you. Managers Bertha Cruz and Raven Lee. Thank you to all sponsors, and a special thank you to the soccer boosters. We appreciate the hard work you always do to go above and beyond. Now let's hear it one more time for your 2016 4A State Soccer Champions, the Dartmoor Sand Lizards.
Will everyone please stand for the presentation of the colors and the playing of the national anthem. This will be followed by the Parish alma mater, then the Dardanelle alma mater, and then this will be followed by a prayer by Dardanelle High School student Alicia Yarborough. Please remove your hats at this time. The Dardanelle High School Junior ROTC Color Guard is commanded tonight by Cadet Angelique Antrim. Color Guard team members are Cadet Nick Johnson, Cadet Ayona Wester, Cadet Megan Yandel, Cadet McKenna Etheridge. The flag-raising detail is commanded by Cadet Charlie Jones. The team members will be Cadet Darren Marcox, Cadet Michaela Jones, Cadet Gage Judkins, Cadet Courtney Riesinger, and Cadet Heather Gilbreth. Now we will have a prayer by the Darnell High School student, Alicia Yarbrough.
Please bow your head with prayer. Lord, thank you for this day. Thank you for everything you've given us, and thank you for the opportunity to be out here. Lord, I ask that you keep the football players safe tonight, and that you just let everybody else know that they're loved. Let the judges and the referees make the right calls tonight and keep everybody safe as they go home. Thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Welcome to Lizard Live pregame. Your Dardanelle Sand Lizards will face the Paris Eagles on a beautiful night for football.
Nice for a prettier evening.
Welcome, Mr. Russell Brown. And we'll be here tonight to take care of all the action for you tonight. Have a little pregame here with the band this evening. Russell, seems like it's been about 3 weeks since we played our last ball game.
Now, I know it, boy. It seems like it has been a long time, and I tell you what, I'm ready for some football tonight, boy.
After the other night, we had some things that we knew that was going to be addressed. Hope we see some results tonight, which I know number one of those we're going to be tackling.
Well, I guarantee you, Coach Vega, I watched practice a couple days this week, and I do believe that that was one of the fundamentals that they worked on was hitting, wrapping up, and I did also see Coach Hardaway working with the line pretty good as far as making sure they get their heads on the right side during blocks and all that stuff. So hopefully, with all the preparations that they put into it, hopefully we'll see a...
We're not in Destin, Florida, but it is beach night.
Yes, it is. We have some beach goers out there. I see a shark or two, and
Landon Bryson,
see a lifeguard.
Landon Bryson is looking good in the visor upside down, sporting the American flag. Thank goodness he doesn't have Speedos on. Just about like last Tuesday, intensity is going to be a big thing.
Yeah, they're going to have to keep keep the motivation going, and you know, and we've talked about this before, but you know, even though we did get the loss last week, I sure was proud of how the kids stayed in there and fought right till the bitter end.
Sure did. You know, this is going to be a huge week to get us back on a winning side of things. Paris is very their skilled players are very good. A lot of athletes up there in the skilled positions. Matter of fact, that would absolutely be the strength of their team will be their skilled positions. That number nine receiver is a dandy-looking kid.
Yeah, saw him. I was up there watching the junior high ball game last night and saw him out there in his street clothes, and he was a pretty good-looking young man.
Says 6 foot 175, but from up here at the booth, it looks about 6'3". 210.
He might be like bringing down a Mack truck.
He's almost as tall as Jimmy Witt.
That's right.
Defensive side of the ball, we talked about a while ago, but Coach Vega had stressed this week, tackle, tackle, tackle. I know they got to do a better job wrapping up, making plays on defense. You know, we had some people in position last Tuesday. Just could not make the play.
Yeah, and one of the things that goes along with that, too, is I know that we had some boys that weren't feeling good. We did have a Tuesday night ball game, and I do know that there was about five or six of them that ended up not going to school the next day due to the stomach bug or whatever it was.
Had a little stomach issue, I believe.
Yes, sir.
You know, last week, try to get those first game jitters out. A lot of new kids, a lot of fresh faces. Never been on a high school ball field before.
Well, and just like in any situation, when you go from, you know, seventh grade football to junior high, it's a big step there, and especially when you get these sophomores coming up from junior high. And we had a couple guys last week that really stood up, and I think that as time goes on, they'll even get better and better.
I agree. We're about 220 from kickoff, and Paris
stands are filled up and they're still coming in.
Great crowd, and all on our feet for pregame. And the band does a great job with the pregame show. It was shortened a little bit because of our 2016 4A soccer state champions received their rings tonight, and some support was shown, and some recognition of support was shown to some good supporters of the soccer program. Proud of those kids. I think maybe all of them, but maybe one coming back.
I believe that's right. I believe I heard Ed when he was talking there said we only had one senior off that team last year.
Not to put any pressure on Coach Hardaway,
no.
Coach Ernest, and Coach Ross. But, you know, if they don't get it done again, you know, there might be an issue there.
That's right.
Because they're all coming back. But 4A soccer is a very competitive thing. So you got CAC, who's always there. You got some of those schools that are always there. It's kind of neat. Of late, we're always there too.
That's right. So, that's a good problem to have.
It is. So, athletics in general has been pretty good at Darnell for the last few years, and a good foundation and a good base to continue with that. About 58 seconds on the pregame clock, and we'll get this thing started offensively tonight. Russell, I don't think anything else could be said, but we need to keep on holding the ball. We cannot have turnovers.
Yeah, we've got to fix those mental mistakes that we had last week, and And again, you know, once again, I think that they have put some preparation in place that, you know, hopefully we should correct those problems. Because a lot of the stuff that we saw last week happen was just, you know, small mistakes that that can be worked on. And I have no doubt that our coaching staff will, they'll shore that up pretty quick, I believe.
The other big issue with that is, you know, there's three different yard lines out here. 50 being in red and both 20s being in red.
Yeah, that's right.
And I'm going to tell you, when we get inside that 20 headed to the goal line, we have got to do something with the football.
Well, we had opportunities last week that, you know, where we got a fumble, picked it up, run it back. And I had some other opportunities there where we were inside the red zone and we came away with no points. And I'm sure that Coach Vega has addressed that issue. And, you know, anytime with the kicker that we have, anytime we get on this on our side of the 50, we should be deadly. So that's one of the things that I know they're working on. We got our captains coming out on the field tonight.
Looks like our captains starting on the left when they get turned will be big number 63, Caden Brown. Number 15, Nick Curris. Number 5, Coda Rowland. And number 29, the one and only Jose Shark Parra, Mr. Smiley himself. I'm just thankful that we can see the numbers across the field a little better tonight.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, last week with that black on black that Charleston had, it was pretty difficult to see the numbers. Looks like we got for Paris number 28.
Aaron Sheffield.
Number 54. And number 60.
Bryant. And number 60, Dante Stanford. Once again, we don't have the officials' names, but in a play or two, we'll be able to call them all kinds of names.
That's right.
I think we handled ourselves real well last Tuesday night at Charleston.
Oh yeah. You know, again, just like we've talked about, man, it's we kind of have to refrain, hold ourselves back, rein ourselves pretty hard, because. Those of you that have seen me out in the stands in the past years, y'all know I like to voice my opinion.
We will receive the kickoff. Week 2 of Dardanelles High School football season. The Junior Lizards traveled to Paris last night, and along with the 7th grade Sand Lizards. Both of them came home with a victory. 7th grade Lizards came home, I believe, 14-8 on a maybe a last-second little trickery. They did a little bounce pass out into the flats, did about a three-bounce hop out there, and young man picked it up and was supposed to throw it deep to the receiver that was wide open, but he panicked a little bit and ran it for about 70 yards.
Well, I tell you what, 6 points is 6 points any way you slice it.
So, and then junior high totally dominated 34-0.
Well, here comes our Sand Lizards running out on the field. We're in our home red on red. Paris is in the white with the blue bottoms. I don't know about you, John David, but buddy, anytime I hear this fight song, see these kids running out, I'm fired up, boy.
I am too.
The Sand Lizards will be led tonight by head coach Bill Vega. The co-offensive coordinator will be Coach Blake Short. The co-offensive coordinator, Coach Brian Hardaway.
I'm going to tell you, been a lot of places, coached a lot of different places at a lot of different away venues, but I'm going to tell you, this is a pretty ball field.
It is. And one of the things that I like, if you got Mount Nebo to the west of us, and, boy, it usually has a beautiful sunset.
When that sun's coming down, it makes a pretty place.
Yes, it does.
Nebo in the background.
And, you know, we were talking about some of these fields, you know, when they're turned north and south, you know, like I know for Paris, for example, they're north and south, and their home bleachers, man, you get eat up with that sun. And just like over at Atkins, the visitors' bleachers, that sun's pretty bright till probably right after the first quarter's over with.
Looks like number 44, excuse me, for Paris, Chris Graham will be your kicker tonight. Paris comes up in a more traditional kickoff formation. Charleston came out and did the little bunch stuff and all the little trickery and all that little stuff last week. Back deep for your Lizards, and looks like number one this week, Kyle Smith, Carter Chandler.
Like Dakota rolling with the ball.
A little bit of trickery.
Still going.
Carried that one, and I don't see any laundry on the field either. Dakota Rowland with a great carry to about the, looks like about the 32-yard line maybe.
Yep, they had some good blocking out there
great
for him.
Blocking.
Had a good lane for him to run.
I'm going to tell you, David Fraley was in suicide mode there. When they do that starburst and he gets that back turn, he has no idea, and there's somebody coming to get him on purpose.
I guarantee you.
Offense comes out on the field tonight. Elias Carter at quarterback. We got twins anchored on both sides. I got Dakota Rowland flanked to his right. Elias takes a snap, runs an option to the right. And Dakota looked like he forgot to carry out his option with him. Gave us a generous spot of about a yard.
Yeah.
Second down and nine. Trips left. Lyson shotgun formation again. Paris is scrambling around a little bit on defense. A little bit of confusion. Not as much as
Boy,
we
had
right
a
then.
Had a bad snap there. I don't think a quarterback was ready for that one, but anyhow, we got the ball back.
How that kept from being in Paris's hands right there, I do not have any.
No,
it must have caught them by surprise.
Yeah,
too.
I believe it did. Caught our linemen and caught their whole defensive on surprise, looked like.
Be 3rd and 13. We're going the opposite direction. 3rd and 13. Tate Vessel comes in as an H-back. Ooh. That
defense
going to be pretty right
no,
there.
No, they sniffed that now right there, boy.
Brings up 4th and 13. Ball's at the 35. Coach Vega is having a small discussion with Elias. Timo comes out. T's going to be placed at about the 43-yard line. Got a timeout on the field.
I didn't even see the clock here.
Yeah, we were down to about nothing. We did get the ball snapped before the timeout, but or as the ball was snapped, I had a timeout there. 10:38.
Yeah, Coach Vega didn't look too happy right there, and he still seems to be not well pleased.
A tad bit aggravated with some offensive performance. Probably,
I believe so.
Did not care for what we just saw there for that
I don't think
series.
He wanted to burn that timeout, but we really had no choice right there.
10:38 left in the first quarter. 4th and 13, balls on the 35. Timo Martinez. Oh.
That one missed by about 3 foot. What would that have been? That would have been a 54-yarder, I believe.
Yes, sir. Paris will take over, 1st and 10 at the 20-yard line. Had that long return. We needed something out of that a little bit.
Yes, we did.
Paris gets it 1st and 10. Remember, their skill kids are pretty good.
Looks like
we have two people in motion there. Tad bit of confusion on everybody's part.
I believe it was.
Like right
had a procedure penalty. That'll bring it back 5 more.
1st and 15 for the Eagles at their own 15. spread them wide and see what happens here.
It almost looked like they still had two men in motion there. One guy may have left a little early. They got a big gain on that play.
I already saw something there that makes me really nervous.
Yeah.
When he rode to his right in option formation, corner left the one going deep to come
yes,
up to try to
did.
Help in the run support. And he could have thrown it on deep to get the other guy, but he came underneath. First and 10 at the 40.
Well, we got a flag down. I believe they're going to get him for procedure that time.
I'm telling you, it was every time. It was all three times a while ago. That is close. Two of them can't be in motion at the same time.
No, sir.
I'm glad to see that being watched there. That was makes me feel a little better. That'll bring first and 15.
Boy, we need a big stop right here.
Brings
running back out wide here.
It's pretty good. Way to stay at home.
He might have got number about 4 yards on that one.
Comes in motion there. Be second down and probably about 11, looks like, for the Paris Eagles. Preston Drury, your quarterback for the Eagles.
Pass was complete.
Got a gain of about 6, looks like. Bring up third and a long 4. Third and a long 4, ball at the 46-yard line.
Oh, we need a good stop right here.
That was just an eye formation, load up on the right side, and that's just a regular sweep to the right.
We used to call that the old quick pitch.
Yeah, that's all it was. That'll be enough for a Paris Eagle first down. Be first and 10. Paris will move pretty quick. First and 10 at the 44. Pair splits two wide. 4 comes in motion.
Oh, we got movement everywhere.
We got about 12 guys in motion. We need to realize. They need to realize this is not Canadian football.
You can't get a running start towards that line of scrimmage. They'll get you every time, boy.
It'd be good. That'll be first and 15. We'll take it all the way back anytime they want to give us back.
Is that about the third penalty on them?
I believe so. At least second procedure penalty. Be first and 15 at the 50. Ball's on the nose of the 50. Quarterback's in the backfield empty. Got trips left. Twins to the right. Looks at the sidelines for more information. They got a beautiful little color chart over there that nobody has any idea what it means. Just act like they do. Quarterback's back in the shotgun formation.
Well, he got I think they're going to give him about 2 yards on that carry. Ball spotted on about the 44-yard line of Dardanelle. Quarterback under center looked like another quick pitch out there to number 9. He turned the corner. He got bumped out of bounds by Canyon Taylor, I believe. Well, I tell you what, we're gonna have to hold that corner over on the end. They're getting that edge on us right now.
Russell, I had ease away there to take a phone call from Mr. Terry Standards to tell me to turn the volume up, but. Were they in I formation, that last one?
Like yes, they were, just like under center.
Got I formation. Out of this, you can also hit that number four, the H-back over there. He can run a good route. The tight end's going to run a route.
Oh, fumble. Oh, and he got the pitch away. Oh, boy.
And right there was a great example. We had three red jerseys standing there looking at the kid as he's coming to him. Instead of coming and attack him, they're sitting there to see if somebody else is going to make the tackle.
We have got to get aggressive on that defense.
I just said more than I needed to say there, but we've got to come make a tackle.
Another first down for Paris. Ball spotted on about the 34-yard line of Dardanell.
He first and 10 at the 34-yard line of the Lizards. Basically a pistol formation. Oh.
There we go. Caden Brown got him in the backfield there for about a 2-yard loss maybe.
Wallered him up and held him up just long enough to let some other Lizards come pounce on him. That brings second down and about 12 for the Paris Eagles.
We need some more of those plays right there, I guarantee you.
Second down and 12, ball's at the 36-yard line of the Sand Lizards.
Got good pressure on the quarterback. Got the ball away. We have got to wrap up. About three guys hit him right there and just couldn't hang on. The good thing there is he only got a couple yards, so.
Bring third down and 6.
Brock Finkenbinder is getting the start tonight, I believe, on the anchor end.
Yes, sir.
Sophomore out there. Got a pitch coming out this way.
Everybody was sucked inside. Somebody's got to have containment out there. The end's getting kicked his tail over there. We've got to have containment.
Well, it's going to bring up fourth down about a long 4.
I hate to be vanilla here, but I'd line up an I formation and sweep it to the right one more time.
They have got a lot of yard over there, that's for sure.
We're in shotgun formation, got trips right.
Well, we got a couple of flags down. I know that he did not make the first down. We got to see what the flag is here.
Got a couple of flags down. We're hoping it's going to be turnover on downs.
Boy, it wouldn't hurt my feelings at all.
Got to hold it on Paris. It'll be declined. It'll be Dardanell Sand Lizards ball taking over on what looks to be about the 29-yard line.
That's what I would call it right there. Well, hopefully we'll get some get us some offense going here. We need to. That last possession we had did not turn out near like what I hoped it would.
A little confusion out there. I have no idea what's going on at all. I think he had some blood maybe on his shin, maybe. So the officials got it stopped. We're in shotgun formation.
Empty backfield. Not a bad run there. He ended up with about, I won't say, probably 6 yards on that one.
Pretty good cut back there. Good cut back there by number 6, Kanan Taylor. Bring up second down and a long 3 for your Lizards at their own 36-yard line. Kanan Taylor in motion. Lies takes a snap, runs option short side of the field. Great read keep it. There. That'll be enough for a first down.
Yep, they'll move the chains.
Be first and 10 at our own 41. First and 10. Official winds the clock. 4:07 left in the first quarter. 0-0. He brings Kanan in motion. Lies takes a snap.
Oh,
in and
boy,
out.
Boy, that was almost right there. Boy, if he'd have caught that one, he'd have been off to the races.
Pretty good defense there by number 42. Just got enough hand in it to take care of it. We need to position and fight for that one right there.
You know, I've been noticing, you know, I noticed last week and this week too, neither team just about going out of a huddle.
Second down and 10. Oh,
and he caught it.
Great concentration.
It was bobbled around. That defensive man had his hand in there on that, but Kanan was able to come up with a catch. Going to give us another first down.
First and 10, balls on the Paris Eagles 43-yard line.
Well, we're moving the ball a little bit better this series.
Mike's flanked with twins on both sides.
Boy, I don't know what happened there. We had Lyman pulling to the right.
I'll be honest with you, I thought Dakota Rowland had the football. And then next thing I know, I realized Elias still had it because all 12 of them or 13 or 14
yeah,
of them was chasing
there was
him.
A herd of them over there.
Bring up second down and 13. Ball's at the 47-yard line. We sputtered when we crossed the 50 a while ago.
Yes, we did.
Well, I guess we started on the other side of the 50 of the last possession. Brings Kanan Taylor in motion. Last rolls.
Carter Chandler with the catch.
Ooh. Oof. That hurt my feelings right there.
Well, I believe he got tattooed right there.
It wouldn't have been so bad, but he was making a spin move, and he had his joystick all spun out there and just got hammered. Bring up third down and 2, which is much more manageable. I'm going to say third down and 3.
Like we're going with an unbalanced line. Somebody, I believe Elias slung a shoe out there.
He ran out of a shoe.
You know, back in the day, J.D., I had that trouble myself.
Did you now?
Yes, I did.
You're so fast, you just came right out of it.
I was like a lightning bolt. So that's what they used to call me, lightning bolt Brown.
Looks like we lost two shoes. Or maybe we're – looks like Chase Hickey's tying his shoe. That'll bring up first and 10 at the 26-yard line of the Paris Eagles. 2:26 left in the first quarter. Russell, this quarter is going a little faster than we did last Tuesday.
Yes, it is. I tell you what, boy, last week it seemed like that quarter lasted for about a half an hour or longer.
Be first and 10 at the 26-yard line of Paris.
Elias Carter will be.
There was a hole there for a second.
Down to the Paris 24-yard line.
And it filled in a hurry.
Yes, it did.
2:05. Ticking on the clock. Second and 8. Ball's at the 24 of Paris. As of right now, we got Elias in shotgun formation. We got wings flanked on either side.
Carter Chandler with the pitch. He looks like he's going to make the corner there.
Great block out there.
That's some good blocking out there.
Bring up third and maybe one or two.
I'm going to say probably one. Crowd's really getting behind them, boy. They're hollering at them to go.
Go, Red, go.
Brings up third down and 2 for the Sand Lizards.
Not much there.
Well, I tell you what, I don't know about that. No, it looks like we got somebody down. Who is that, Bailey? Yeah, Bailey. Wonder if he's messed that ankle up again. I know he had sprained it pretty bad last week.
Grabbed his knee, it looked like.
I believe he's bringing in the heavy crew right here.
Fourth and two. Fourth and maybe a long one.
Looks like we're going to have an unbalanced line here. Boy, that's going to be close right there.
I'm going to say.
I believe they may have it.
I'm going to say we got it. From up here, looks like we got it.
He's
great job. First and 10. First and 10.
You know, I tell you what, that one right there looked about like I play golf. Ugly but effective.
First and 10. Ball's at the Paris Eagle 15. Here's where we got to make something happen.
Quarterback keeper going off there to the right, left side. Yep, we got a flag thrown.
Where that's at, that's not a good thing.
No, I think I think we might have a little hold in there. Yes, and that's what the call was.
Can't take the big gun out and shoot ourselves in the foot.
No, sir, we cannot.
Changing packages up, bringing the receivers back out on the field, spreading us out a little bit. That's a big one. That's a 10.
Receiver open. Carter Chandler still on it.
He don't wrap
that's
up.
That's right. You have got to squeeze them arms, boy.
Carter Chandler scoots in from about 25 out. And give your Sand Lizards a 6-0 lead with 6 seconds left to go in the first quarter.
You know, again, I tell you what, that might not have been the prettiest play, but, hey, six is six any way you look at it.
And he tiptoed right down the sidelines there after he ran over – after he ran over our boy there.
Team O put it through, make it 7-0. 6 seconds left to go in the first quarter. I don't know if y'all can hear it or not, but boy, that band is hammering right now.
Sorry for the little pause there. We hope you got the touchdown. To be honest with you, we were caught up and don't know. We think we might have been off for a few minutes there. And once again, remember, we all enjoyed, we all love it when it's working. Sand Lizards 7, Paris Eagles 0. 6 seconds left to go in the first quarter. I'd love for Timo to put this one in the end zone.
Yeah, I'd like to see this and roll
it
back.
Hey, look here. Look
in.
Here. I wonder if Charleston let us borrow their tee.
Hey, or somebody might have went to Walmart and got one this week.
I bet you Timo had it.
I bet you he had it duct taped to him.
I guarantee it. Timo approaches the ball.
Oh, that's a good kick right there, boy.
And we'll
and
take that one every time.
Out of the end zone. I'll tell you what, JD, it wouldn't hurt my feelings if we did that every time we kicked the ball.
Oh, Lord, no. And I'll just be honest with you, I hope he hurries up. And I want to keep him here for another 2 years or
yep.
For this year, next year. But he sure would look good with the hog on the side of his helmet.
Yes, he would.
Because I watched them the other day and what did we score, 3 touchdowns?
Yeah.
And gave up a whole lot of return yards because we couldn't get it in the end zone.
That's exactly right.
Paris takes over first and 10 at their own 25. Got a pitch and catch out here in the flat to number 9. Short gain of about 3 yards. 3 yards. That'll be the end of the first quarter. Well, your Dardanelle Sand Lizards 7, Paris Eagles 0. We'll be back in just a few.
Around 2 yards on the play, second down and 8 for the Eagles. They'll have the ball.
Defender! Defender!
The Gridiron is selling raffle tickets for a Yeti Tour and Cup.
Welcome back. Start the second quarter. Dardanelle Sand Lizard 7. Paris Eagles 0. Paris takes over. Start the second quarter on the 22-yard line.
Well, I'll tell you what, we need a good stand on defense right here. Wouldn't hurt my feelings to keep that ball on this side of the 50.
Got twins on both sides. Brings four in motion.
Little fake handoff there. Caden missed him in the backfield, and he has got some running room. Got a flag
and
on the play.
We're going to have probably late hit out of
bounds. Yeah, I believe that's what it's going to be.
Because sometimes, I mean, there's no sense in that. I mean, there is no – you've already gained 20 yards, and you're going to give them another 10 or more. Personal foul.
Personal foul.
I believe that's going to be on number 5.
You know, I mean, I love to hit that'll anybody just like the next guy, but, man, you have got to hold up over on that sideline.
That'll be a 15-yarder.
Paris hurrying up to the line.
They're going
to
go in a hurry. Twins on both sides. Preston Drury.
Hand off to the motion man. Well, ball. Looks like we got
and
the
we'll
ball right
it,
there.
I believe. And we've got holding everywhere on the field. I think that was a fumble.
Holding decline.
We're going to have
Dardanelle
a first down, Dardanelle
football.
Lizards.
Well, there's a first break right there of the night, J.D.
We'll take it any way we can.
Just like I said, hey, we only had it 4 yards on the other side of the 50. I almost called that
one.
Here
we go. It's going to take them a while to pick up all the laundry.
We got yellow flags everywhere out there. Looks like we'll have the ball spotted on, looks like, what to be the 46-yard line.
Dardanelle takes over, first and 10. As Russell said, on the 46, our own 46-yard line. Last back at quarterback, flanked to his right by Dakota Rowland. Twins on both sides.
Oh!
Was that not a horse collar?
Whoa, man.
We can't give up that 5-yard loss.
No, he's you know, then again, I think there you go. You got your sophomore inexperience. When you get like that, you have got to cut that ball loose.
He did the right thing by not throwing it down the field.
Yeah, they had them covered up pretty good.
He needed to get rid of it. Be second and 15. And we're going to have us a little motion, I would assume. Yes, it is. Be about second and 20.
Boy, I tell you what, that's what we do not need.
Got to capitalize on a turnover. Be second down and about 20, give or take a yard probably. Looking for the sidelines for some direction. Coach Hardaway signals in the play. Elias is a quarterback, flanked to his left by Dakota Rowland. Got twins on both sides.
Good cut right there. Oh, he's there you go.
Great play right there. Good read by the quarterback.
That was a good one there.
Because he didn't have anything on the pitch there. They were coming out and took care of that, and Elias was able to cut it back upfield. That's
But I tell you what, if we do that all night right there, hey, that was a gain of about probably 12 yards.
I'm going to say about 15.
Yeah, it may have been, yep.
Third and about 5 for your Lizards. We go from trips to quads. Oh! We got a flag on the opposite side of the field. We're either going to have motion or we might have a defensive lined up offsides.
I don't know what that one is.
If it had been motion, I think they would have called us dead at the snap. No flag on
no
the play.
No flag on the play. Well, I don't believe we gained anything on that one. If we did, it might have been a yard.
It is fourth down. Fourth and five.
Down to about six on the play clock.
We're going to use our second timeout here to discuss the fourth and five. Whether we're going to go for it or pin them maybe deep. 9:47 left to go in the second quarter. Dardanelle Sun Lizards 7, Paris Eagles 0.
Well, J.D., one thing that we cannot do is do the two-stepping with our offense. Gain 10 and have to hop back 5 or 6. And, you know, we had 3 penalties on this drive so far, three.
We can't afford that. We don't have the big play capability.
It's just going to come down to it, you know, throughout the season. We're going to have to play error-free football. And, I can't put it any tamer, any blank, you know, I mean, that's just what it's going to come down to. They got
fundamentals. I mean, just basic fundamentals. It looks like we're going to line up and go for it. Fourth and five. Cannon Taylor in motion.
Roll out to the left. Oh, and we got a catch there. Carter Chandler.
Go-to receiver there. Nice play there. Good job on Elias's part there to even see him. He had two receivers coming short. Had two other receivers on down the field. Carter Chandler. First and 10 at the 31 of Paris.
He's got some pressure on him. Dadgummit.
I still chalk that up on inexperience and not knowing. He's got to throw that ball away.
Yeah, you roll out there and you got that ball. Once you're outside of that tackle box, if there's nothing there, you gotta let her go.
Got to play a little more with our head there. He's second and a long 18. Good hard run right there.
See another shoe out there on the ground. Chase Hickey lost a shoe again.
Somebody might have to teach him how to tie that shoe.
Called a double knot.
Looks like third down and about 8 for your Lizards. Ball's played about the 28-yard line.
We hadn't had that loss of yards right there. That might have been enough for a first down.
We have officials timeout. As Hickey ties his shoe. Somebody might need to tie him in a double knot. Third and 18. Ball's at the 20, or excuse me, third and about 8.
Yeah.
Ball's at about the 28-yard line.
Dakota rolling with the ball. Come out here. Looks like he might have. Oh, now.
Excuse me.
I believe that's what happened over on the other side.
I think some of our fans noticed that. But
yes, sir, I do believe it did. I'm surprised I didn't hear Sherry Hicks voicing her opinion on that one.
I sure thought I wasn't even looking at that yardstick over there. I just assumed as much as he ran, we got that one, but obviously we didn't. Fourth and a long 1.
Looks like we got the jumbo package in there. Good block by Tate Vestal.
Good run, good block. Cut it up inside.
Tate had a good block. That's right there is what gave him the corner. It's like we got DJ Brown checking in the ball game.
Be first and 10 at the Paris Eagle. Looks like to be about the 18-yard line. Paris is going to call a timeout, which is going to be a good thing for us. We'll take that anytime. Sand Lizard's driving. 8:07 left to go in the second quarter. Your Dardanelle Sand Lizard 7, Paris Eagles 0. Ball's on the 18-yard line of Paris. Be first and 10 when we come back. And we're back, first and 10 at the Paris Eagle 18. We need to capitalize. We're in the red zone. Elias Carter at quarterback. We got twins on both sides, bringing Tate Todd Vestal into motion.
Quarterback keeper going right up the pipe. Look at there.
Counted as a touchdown.
Look at there. I believe that's six right there.
Touchdown, Dardanelle Sand Lizards. Elias Carter scampers in from 18 out.
I'll tell you what, those linemen, they look like the Red Sea parting out there, boy.
They did a good job. And I tell you, Elias did something that he did a lot last year. He just was real patient, snuck his way through, didn't get in a big hurry, and let the linemen move around and let those defensive linemen run out of spots and let his receivers get everybody downfield. Timo Martinez in for the extra point. Ball's down, kicks up, and we're going to say it's going to be good. With 8:01 left to go in the second quarter, Dardanelle Sand Lizards 14, Paris Eagles 0. Got a quick announcement. Basketball Booster Club, Fishing Tournament, October the 1st at the Dardanelle Lake Coach Tournament. April Metcalf, your Basketball Booster Club president. Coach Sturdivant, you can contact either one of those and get some information on the Basketball Booster Club Fishing Tournament. Get out and support. Also, our Football Booster Club is doing a Yeti giveaway. I believe it's maybe six chances for $5, maybe, or a dollar a chance.
I believe that's what it is.
And I believe you get two Yeti cups and a nice Yeti cooler.
And somebody told me Jimmy Witt would throw in one of them big Yeti coffin coolers there, I think.
One of them bags?
Yeah, no, one of them big.
He's got one of them big bags.
I'm talking about one of them coolers big enough I could hop off in there, boy.
It's
big enough to have its own steering wheel. It just don't have one.
Timo gets the ball down.
Ooh. Bounce, rolling around there at about the 6-yard line. He run right towards it.
Good coverage right there. We'll take that.
It almost looked to me like he run right towards that big pile of red over. I don't know now.
It's almost like he went right to us, and I was tickled for that. He knuckleballed that one. Coach Walter is talking to him a second. But anyway, that was kind of an odd that one's an odd one to field there. Harris takes over first and 10. At about the 19-yard line, their own 19-yard line.
Oh, Caden got him back here in the backfield this time.
Good pursuit.
He might have come down the line. He might have listened to me by hanging on to him.
And good job. And once again, had him wrapped up long enough to have some other red jerseys come in and help. You made mention about Brock. I talked to Coach Vega this afternoon or this morning, and Brock played in a JV game on Tuesday night at Pottsville, and said he made lots of plays. Of course, you know, a little different setup tonight, but same game, you know.
Slinging it out there.
Oh. just almost too high for the receiver. But
now, I'm not much of a secondary expertise, but is that a big cushion that we're giving those boys out there?
It is a little cushion, not quite like the Razorbacks' 25-yard man or zone cushion, but we're pretty close. Pretty close. I think we're so scared of getting beat deep. I think we, right now you've got third and one and we're setting about 10 yards off.
Paris calls another timeout.
They're going to talk about it. It is a crucial third down. Third and one at their own 27-yard line. 6:47 left to go in the second quarter.
Who was that boy? He's playing up there for the Razorbacks this year that – about 6'1", 270 that run them kickoffs back last year in high school. Who was that?
Oh, Kevin McGee.
Yeah, that's who it was. I never did get to watch that, but boy, howdy, I believe that would have been fun to watch.
He played well a little bit the other day.
Yeah, he did. I did see him go in the game. All right, we're ready to go again.
Be third and one. Big play here. Under center. I formation. They've hurt us on the sweep. Quarterback going to get drugged across the line. And looks like he's going to fall forward just barely enough for a first down.
Yep, they're going to move the sticks.
Be first and 10 for the Paris Eagles, just inside their own 30. Quarterback doing some adjustment, trying to get 44 where he wants him. Brings four in motion. Four has been in motion a whole lot tonight.
Looks like he's not well. I said he wasn't going to get much. They're going to give him about 6 yards or seven, maybe even eight.
I'm not whining. Well, I guess I am, but there is no way that a wide receiver can block in the open field with their hands and arms exposed and not hold.
Well, it's just like some of those pictures I saw from the Charleston game. I believe they was in the Southwest Times record up there in Fort Smith, and it says somebody threw a good block, and, he had a bear hug on one of our linebackers.
Well, of course, if they call something, they could probably call
something. Ball!
And we're going to get it back.
I believe we got it.
Our big Caden Brown found a Twinkie again.
There we go.
There it was. Same Twinkie he found last week.
That's what it was. He said, looky what I got.
That's two turnovers. We'll take it.
Yes, sir. We've got points. I don't know who that big fella was that got that ball.
Be first and 10 for the Lizards at the Paris Eagle. Slot back, H-back is Tate. AKA used to be fullback before they got all fancy.
Pretty good time to throw the ball there.
Thank you, sir. Woo. And we didn't throw
know.
It to who we needed to.
Boy, we had, who is this right here?
That'd be Kanan Taylor. That's, yeah, who, son, he that's who Coach Vega wanted him to throw to by what
open.
I could – by the mannerisms and the arm waving that I could see from Coach Vega, Elias might have caught the wrong receiver.
You know, I don't know if you could get any more open than what he was right there.
Got wing to the right, Carter Chandler.
Oof. And that went nowhere.
Hello, Chase Hickey forgot to block his gentleman. Be third. And a
it helps. It helps when you get in front of them.
Third and a long 13 for the Sand Lizards at the Paris Eagle 36-yard line. Looking to the sidelines.
Is it me or why do we look so confused out here?
I don't know, but we got about 10 seconds left on the play clock.
Boy, they're running like chickens out there. Had to barn another timeout.
5:22 left to go in the first half. St. Lizard's 14, Paris Eagles 0. Hey, guess what? We can't do another one like that.
No, we can't.
Used them all up.
Yep. We're slap dab out of timeouts.
Thank goodness it's not the second half, and thank goodness we had the lead for now. But, you know, we might need that towards the end of the half. But anyway, that's the way it goes. I am a little concerned about the little bit of the confusion that was taking place out there. Not a little, I'm a whole lot.
Yeah, there was a lot of confusion on that play right there.
And I don't know if we were concerned about personnel or where we were going or what the play was, but a little bit of confusion. Bring up third down, still on about 13. Ball's at the Paris Eagle 36-yard line. 5:22 left to go in the second quarter. It has became night real quick and become dark.
See the beautiful skyline of Dardanelle.
It is.
Right there to the north of us.
It's nice, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
It's beautiful. Beautiful. The little steam that Tyson's putting off down the road. Lyles Carter drops back.
Plenty of time to pass. Finds his man right there.
Canaan Taylor. Great play, great catch. And I'm afraid. Get up, Canaan Taylor.
Hop up there, Biggin.
Get up, Biggin. You can get your breath. Oh, we just lost your mouthpiece. Oh, we're good. We're good. We shook it off.
Took a little.
It's in the pocket.
I believe he's still feeling it just a little bit.
I think you got the air knocked out of him a little bit.
Well, that gave us a first down here.
First and 10. That was a huge pickup there. First and 10 at the 18.
Good hole right there. Lies keeps the ball.
Great job there. Great call. Great play. Kanan's going to come out and get his ribs and things put back in place. And I watched that NFL game last night where they had the oxygen, you know, on the sidelines of Denver. He might need a tad bit of oxygen. Elias back at quarterback. We have second and 3. Ball's at about the 13-yard line of the Paris Eagles.
Oh, fumble. Dadgummit.
Ball still on the ground.
I don't know who's got it there.
We got it
we
back,
might have.
That was unbelievable. It went through about 4 or 5 people.
Looked like a greased pig running around out there on the field.
I believe he's not going to get that opportunity to carry it again right this second. We can't have the ball on the ground.
Not, especially not down here where we're at right now. We have got to capitalize.
That's going to be enough for a first down time. We kicked it, fumbled it, and dropped it, and pushed it forward. And Paris couldn't follow on it either. Be first and goal from about the 7.
Pretty
great
good
block.
Hole there. Oh,
and we're
we
gonna
got
have
a flag
hold.
On the play. Doggone.
I'm going to say a hold, but I could be wrong. But where it's at, there's a bunch of people piled up. I'm going to say that somebody might have been on. I didn't see it, but I'm not saying it didn't happen.
Face mask, I believe what they're calling.
Sure enough. Let's cancel it and take the touchdown. Why don't you say?
I vote for that option.
Or hands to the face. I bet they're going to call hands to the face. And we'll take the touchdown. Mr. Whitehat, shouldn't be much confusion there.
Touchdown.
And we'll take it. 4:13 left to go in the second quarter. Dardanelle 20, Paris 0. I believe there was hands to the face. Maybe I don't think it was a face mask. They looked like they were slapping the head. Assessed on the kickoff is what that's what I figured, since there wasn't anything said. Timo Martinez in to kick the extra point. 4:13 left to go in the second quarter. Timo
Martinez, I believe it's up and good.
It's up and good.
We got 4:13 left to go in the game. Yeah. Dardanelle 21, Paris 0.
Hey, I just got a text message.
Well, that kind of scares me.
From Terry Thone.
And what did Terry say?
Terry says, give the score a little more.
21 nothing, Dardanelle.
What is it?
It's 21, you're Sand Lizard, 21, Paris Eagle 0.
Oh, with 4:13 left to go in the second quarter.
21 nothing.
Terry Thone, it's 21
21-0.
I'm just wondering why you're not here. But anyway, that's a whole other story for another day.
It's not like, you know, we're 100 miles from Dardanelle, you know. But she's probably more comfortable sitting up there in that easy chair. Got the AC hammering. Probably got her a glass of sweet tea.
I will let you know, we are going to stream. We're going to continue going live as far as a video. You won't have to hear us.
Oh, got a little
blip. Hit him, boys.
Ooh,
hit him, boys.
On the ground. Doggone.
We'll take it. We'll take it. Fight for it, boys. And I believe Paris fell on it. Man, that couldn't have been hit to kick to anybody
no,
any better. That was perfect right there. We needed somebody to lay him out and then check on him after it was over.
Yeah, hip him up after you hammer him.
Paris is going to take over. First and 10 at about their own 27-yard line.
J.D., guess what?
Tell me.
It's 21-0.
21-0, 4:09 left to go in the second quarter. Paris is back in I formation, kind of surprising. I wouldn't doubt that they wouldn't do a little fakeroo and throw it somebody.
Yep.
And lo and behold.
Got a back going out there, and I believe we got pretty – ball. No ball on the ground.
No way. They can't call that a
catch.
Look
at there.
We'll take it. There's no way, but we'll take it.
Hey, mercy sakes.
Hey, I've got a new name for that one. That's a nice ref right there.
Yes, sir.
We said before the game we didn't have names for the ref. Give us a few minutes and we'd call some.
That's what he makes me.
There might be some discussion here. White Hat cannot come to the booth and ask for questions. I mean, we've got a video
we've
replay right here.
We've got an instant replay.
And we can tell them.
Called it right.
Hey, I think Jimmy Witt had a bug in that ref's ear and told him to call it.
Well, you know, I saw him talking to him before the game. There may have been an exchange out there. I'm not for
That's
sure.
That's right. I was going to say a while ago before I started rambling about something else, we are going to continue to stay live. The band will be performing at halftime along with our cheerleaders. So you'll be able to watch the Dardanelle Scarlet Regiment, all 4,000 members is what it appears to be.
Yep.
We take over first and 10 at our own 47-yard line.
Bunch of time. Man wide open, Kyle Smith.
Great throw.
To the
great
25-yard line.
Good route by Kyle Smith. Great ball placement by Elias Carter. Looks very comfortable in the pocket on that one.
Yes, he did. Boy, I tell you what, those linemen give him a good opportunity to sit there and
good pocket.
And he could eat a piece of chicken down there before he cut that and loose. And it's 21-0.
21-0. 3:45 left to go in the second quarter. Sand Lizards driving on the 25 of the Paris Eagles. Last brings Cannon Taylor in motion.
Well, we got to go. I don't know what happened there. Once again, somebody might have missed a man because he was in that backfield pretty quick. JD, it's 21-0.
3:03 left. That score is brought to you by Terry Thone. Oh, Kyle's wide open.
Oh,
we'll take that one right there, too.
Carter Channer got her down there. That's going to be a first down.
That'll be enough for a first down as Lies rolled to his left and had some receivers running him out.
Well, I just got the double thumbs up from Terry Thone there on my text, so I think we have appeased her and made her happy.
So we don't have to say the score the rest of the night.
Yeah, that's right.
First and 10, ball's at about the 11-yard line. This is a huge – And I know we're up 21-0, but we'll take any points we can get. And we'll be huge going to halftime and kick up another
back
score.
Back to pass. We got a man open there, Carter Chandler again.
Stay inbound. We'll
game
take
of
that.
About five.
You know, we just need to protect the ball. We'll take – I'd like to have six or seven here, but I'll also take three. We don't need to – We don't need to put the ball on the ground or hand it to them either. Last come to the ball, second and four. Ball's on about the 6-yard line. He's flanked to his left by Dakota Rowland. He brings Kanan Taylor in motion. He's going to roll to the wide side.
Oh,
great catch. Great catch.
On about the 1 foot line. I'll tell you what, he made a hand right there.
That was a great catch. Good hands, great catch. Be honest with you, pretty good ball there by Elias. He had to throw it away from that defender. About the only place he could throw it to was that outside shoulder.
Outside shoulder.
And Carter turned all the way around.
I believe we got the big package in again.
We got big heavy. You and I could be in that package.
Hey, that's tailor-made for me right there.
Got an official's timeout. We're going to measure to see if that was enough for a first down. Looks like it's about the half-yard line. Ball spotted just over the goal line or just inside the one. Be first and goal from about, the foot yard line.
I don't know. If I was just guessing, I think they're going to run to the right.
You think so?
They may
well,
do
unless
it.
Unless we trick them and counter it to that right.
We could
side,
do that.
And lo and behold, run it back to the weak side.
Because I promise you, we are heavy on the right side. Oh, look at there. They're going right. I believe he's in there for a touchdown.
I believe we'll take it. Your Dardanelle Sand Lizards, 27, Paris Eagles, 0. 1:49 left to go in the second quarter. We'll take it.
You know, I'm going to say again,
offensive juggler not tonight.
Yes, sir. We're looking a lot better. We have made some mistakes in the first half, but hey.
Timo
Martinez will be attempting to point after.
Balls down, kicks up, and it is good from about 60.
Oh, and we have a flag out there.
Somebody's not happy.
And the Paris Eagles, 0.
Whatever it is, it's against Paris.
I'm going to say it is. He threw it right at the feet of a Paris Eagle defensive tackle.
Personal foul.
On Paris, somebody wasn't happy with probably a block that was taking place, or maybe the fact that they're getting beat 28 to nothing. Be first and 10
with
for somebody in just a minute.
49 left to go.
What's the score?
28
to nothing.
Your Sand Lizards
over the Paris Eagles. Don't forget, halftime, Dardanelle Scarlet Regiment Band will perform. Dardanelle High School senior cheerleaders will perform. I'm assuming Paris Eagles band will perform. I'm assuming. I think I see them over on the far side. Maybe.
I think he could put it right through the uprights from right there on about the 45.
I would love for that to happen. That'd be sweet. You know, when he was at the Razorback camp, he was averaging about 65 yards a kickoff. You know, he was.
You know, and it helps when you have a tee, I believe.
Yes, sir, it does. And it also helps to have 10 other guys out there that can go tackle.
Yes,
instead of last
it does.
Week having one still on his knee. Timo approaches the ball.
Oh, we're going to try it again. Ball's going to hit the ground. Hit him.
Oh, we can't advance it. Timo with the tackle.
Look at there.
A great kick. Guys got to be on their horses on this
yes,
side of the field.
Yes, they do. Yeah, we have got to put a hat on that guy. We can't let that happen like that.
As good of a kick as that was not very good on our coverage team.
As soon as I saw it hit the ground, I expected to see about three or four red jerseys around it.
Be first and 10 at the Sand Lizard 30 for Paris.
And that
eye formation, power eye, tall sweep.
That
great play, good play out there.
Sir-ree.
Kyle Smith coming up from his corner position.
We got a flag,
and we're going to have
there.
A hold, I think.
It could be. I'm going to call that a bear hug.
That was a great call there, Russell Brown. And if it's not, I will apologize. But from up here, we thought it was.
And he waved it off.
They thought. They saw what we saw.
It was a figment of his imagination.
Maybe it was a figment of our imagination. Be second and 10 from the 30. They move out of the.
That still was a good defensive stand right there. That was textbook. Boy, they slung it right out to the sideline. It gained about maybe 6 inches on that play.
Got tripped right for Paris. Single receiver. Got a screen coming back underneath.
Oh, and that was red. Sniffed out real good.
Ball on the ground. We got it again.
And we got a flag.
I think the ball was on the ground before the flag ever came.
I do, too. They got a powwow out there. Face mask on the defense. Now, what would happen if they declined that? It'd be our football.
Yes, it would be.
We couldn't be that lucky, though.
That hurt us right there.
Yeah. Defense just needs to tighten up right here.
Defense just needs to tighten up, and
they're sniffing that goal line down there. We're gonna have to tighten up and shut them down right here.
That was just in the 5 yard variety. Be second and 5 from about the 25.
Second down and 5 for the Eagles.
Defense doing some shuffling
around.
Got them
spread out.
Oh, Russell, the middle of the field's wide open. And there he is.
And that's what they're throwing at. Oh, and it's picked
off.
Good
play, Kyle Smith. Great play. Good catch.
Son, he is all over that like a duck on a June bug right there, boy.
That's a nice play. I might have called that one.
Well,
I said the middle of the field was open.
Yes, you did. Lo and behold, it became unopened.
Kyle went man-to-man with him, and that was that was a savior for us, because if they'd have been playing zone, it'd have been all over. But we'll take over.
Now,
we'll
I want take your honest that. Opinion. You think Jimmy would have picked that off if he'd been out there?
Well, it depends on what ladder he was on. Be first and 10, 106 left to go in the second quarter. This quarter is taking a little longer.
It has, and it's 28 to nothing.
We just need to protect the football, and I believe colored a good half, just to be perfectly honest with you.
Well, look at there. There's a hole big enough to drive a school bus through.
Just pound them and pound them and pound them. We'll take it. 58
you know, we're moving
counting.
The ball pretty good right up the gut.
Yep.
I mean, you know, there's nothing wrong with all this pass swinging, running out wide, but, boy, I'm telling you what, we have gutted them right up the middle.
About 40 seconds and counting. Be second and 4 on our own about 16-yard line. Last quarter brings Tate in motion.
Good block there. Dakota's got some good blocking out there. Boy, there was a good block by –
oh,
Mr. Bailey Sadler
nice
out there.
Block by Bailey
I guarantee,
Sadler.
Son, he pancaked that boy.
I think that little safety didn't know what hit him.
It's like, Mr. Pain train coming.
25 seconds left to go in the second quarter. It'll be 20 and counting. Probably going to be the last play.
Dakota Rowland got a good block. He's still going.
Well, I'll take that back. We'll have another one.
That boy's just sitting on him out there. Son, he's
clock
about to fire Mr. Farofino up out there.
Well, we've got a new guest to the first Lizard football.
Well,
no, I guess it's probably her second. Is this her second Lizard football game? She was at Charleston last week, so I hate to call her Little Vestal is what I'm going to call her. But that's going to be the end of the first half. Well, your Dardanelle Sand Lizards are 28. Paris Eagles 0.
Well,
Russell,
now
that's a good
half is in the books. Hey, we did some good things. You know, had some mistakes, but hey.
That was a good first half.
This is football. That's going to happen.
We'll take it. I'll take this first half over last week's first half.
Oh, I guarantee you, any day.
Now, here's some things that we need to talk about for the second half. It's 28 to nothing which means we scored 28 points in the first half, which means they could score 28 in the second half if we allow them to.
That's right. The key to the game here is we're going to beat them if we score more points than they do.
You're right. And I can tell you from being in many locker rooms, you're going to hear in the speech in the locker room something about they're going to get griped at about some things they've done wrong. They're going to be praised about some things they've done right. They're going to be hammered about not letting up.
Yeah, you can't let up, even though you got a good lead on them. You still have got to come out that second half with intensity and just keep bearing down, just keep doing what you have been taught. And, but like I say again, I don't think they're going to come out and lay down because they didn't have that attitude last week, and I don't believe that they'll have it this week either.
Russell, we're going to call that a half, and we're going to go away and let you enjoy the halftime festivities here.
We'll hang a microphone out the window, or do we already have
one? We already got one out there, boys.
Hey, we're hooked up and ready to roll.
We're ready to roll. Have a good halftime.
Enjoy your band.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to halftime. The Paris School District is proud to present for your halftime entertainment the Paris High School Marching Eagle Band. The band will be performing the opener tonight to the 2016 show entitled The Music from Star Wars by Academy Award winner composer John Williams. Please welcome drum major Sydney Stokes and the Paris High School Marching Eagle Band to the field as they perform the main theme to the 1977 movie, Star Wars, A New Hope. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together once again for the award-winning Paris High School Marching Eagle Band. The band is being conducted on the field tonight by drum major Sydney Stokes and is under the direction of band directors Corey Michael and Brittany Crosby.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome our 2016-17 senior high cheerleaders and Lonnie. This year's cheerleaders include Maddie Hickenbotham, Jana Reinhardt, Destiny Everett, Brianna Kinder, Haley Sandridge, Hannah Merritt, Courtney Steer, Brittany Keys, and Aaron Reinhardt. And last but never least in everyone's heart, Zoe, also known as Lonnie. All right, ladies.
Good evening. This portion of your halftime entertainment is brought to you by the Dardanelle High School Scarlet Regiment. The band is 163 members strong and directed by Clay Hook, Tina Cornwell, Zachary Whitworth, and Holly Smith. They're being led on the field by drum majors Reagan English and Savannah Harris. And in spirit tonight by Dustin Jones. The band would like to thank the Journey Church, Dardanelle campus, for coordinating drinks for our Wednesday rehearsals and our tailgate parties home and away. Last week's meal was sponsored by Paul and Sue Cellino. Give a round of applause to Paul and Sue. And this week's meal was sponsored by Wayne and Kelly Jones. This year's show is entitled Radioactive. Please enjoy Movement 1 that contains U2's Vertigo and Imagine Dragons' Radioactive. Ladies and gentlemen, the pride of Yale County, the Dardanelle High School Scarlet Regiment! Thank you. ladies and gentlemen, the pride of Yale County, the Dardanelle High School Scarlet Regiment. Now stand to your feet and join in with the fight song, Onward, Lizards! We'll be right back.
Hey, welcome back. Timo Martinez, balls on the ground, balls placed and balls kicked. We squib it again, a little knuckleball. Oh, they do some starburst.
On the return is the golden line.
Not exactly the kickoff that we wanted.
Almost the 35.
Of offense for the second half.
Hand off to the motion man, number four, trying to get that end. And we played that well. I was going to say we played that a lot better.
We played it great, except we forgot to tackle. Got to wrap up. Cannot afford not to wrap up and tackle. Second about six for the Paris Eagles. Got twins right and twins left.
Little swing out pass. That was a pretty good stop right there.
Not much going there. Tackled by three lizards and the down marker.
I thought they was going to throw the flag on that down marker that time. A little extracurricular activity there, Brian.
And we're going to have a timeout because
did they break the down marker?
We're having some technical issues with the down marker. Boater in the middle.
Yes, sir.
I bet you. 10:57. Hope you enjoyed the
score was 28-0. Miss Thone.
Thank you, Terry Thone. Hope you enjoyed the halftime festivities. Or you got to see the Dardanelle High School senior high cheerleaders. And Scarlet Regiment Band. Be third and about six.
Back to pass here. We got some heat coming at him. Oh, that's a good tackle. Oh,
great job. I don't know why the whistle hadn't blown, but that was a great play there. We bring up fourth down and about three, maybe a long two for the Paris Eagles. Ball's just over the 40-yard line.
I believe they're going to go for it. Not have they? And I don't think we have either.
Fourth down and three.
Just don't jump off sides.
Get out wide, boys. They're going to the left.
And he got it. Doggone it.
Oh, he strung him out and had nobody come to fill. Played it perfect as far as containment and had nobody to come up and take care of it.
You know, that's one of the differences I can see from the team last year. We attacked the ball a little bit harder on defense.
First and 10 from the 47.
Oh, wide open. Oh, my goodness.
That was some of that play action stuff that we saw that first possession
first,
they had that scared us a little bit because
brings that corner up. And
everybody draws up and they
thanks.
Throw it over the top.
Like, boy, look at here. We're fixing to stop the run. That one guy just slips right past him, and he dropped the dime in there.
First and 10, just outside the 10.
Boy, look at there. Got around the side.
Had a missed tackle, had him in the backfield, and we dove at his shoestrings.
Well, I don't think that's how we wanted to start the half out right there.
.930 left in the third quarter. Paris finally on the scoreboard. Dardanelle 28, Paris 6. 44 coming out to do the extra point.
See if we can get in here and block this one.
Number 44, Chris Graham.
Straight on kicker. Bad snap, and it, oh.
That was close.
It went through there, boy. We almost, Carter Chandler almost got on that one.
not the first possession on defense that Coach Vega wanted to see.
No, sir.
.930 once again left to go in the third quarter. We're going to send Kyle Smith deep. He's going to be flanked to his left by Dakota Rowland. To his right, as we're looking at it, by Carter Chandler. Once again, David Fraley will be the suicide gentleman.
He is the suicide jockey.
If they run the starburst. Once again, Paris lines up in kickoff formation, just like they did to start the ball game, just in a routine, regular, standard kickoff.
See, he's only about three steps there before he boots it.
Finke
and Binder with the ball, gets it up to about, about 46, 47 yard line?
47 yard line, looks like it's going to be spot right there between the 46 and 47. Be first and 10 for the Lizards, just inside the 50, our own 50-yard line. Russell, I would like to see some of the same thing here on offense that we had the first half. I would love to be able to pick right up where we left
off.
Yeah,
we need to continue to move the ball.
We cannot let Paris gain any type of momentum or sustained momentum. I'm sure they're a little pep in their step with the score, but we need to go and move. Last quarter.
Dakota Rowland, still going. He got about 9 yards on that one.
Great run by.
Had a little help there pushing him with Caden and Isaiah Sferafino.
Great job there. Great job. Matter of fact, they kind of helped pull him a yard or two also.
I believe they did.
Be second and two for your Lizards. Paris. Shins are going to be sore on that one.
Yes, sir.
They shinned him on that one.
You can't run without legs. I found that out.
First and 10, just over the 40-yard line for the Lizards. First and 10, 8:52 left to go in the third quarter. Clock's rolling.
Quarterback keeper.
And
not much doing right
not
there.
Not much doing. They had looked like probably a safety scooted up. And
they had a good line surge that time, and it just closed in on him from the outside.
He came in on him pretty quick. Nobody there to pick him up. Lassa probably hit that hole just a little too slow, trying to wait, let something develop. Bringing some personnel in and out, and we got second and 7. Ball's placed at about the 38 of Paris. Lassa rolls.
Good play right there.
Good play, good catch, good concentration by Kanan Taylor. Way to hang on to the football.
Tell you what, he's making a hand. Kanan is making a hand out there.
I'm telling you, he took a lick there halfway through the second quarter.
Yes, he did.
Be third and a long three for the Sand Lizards. Ball's placed at about the 33 of Paris. Looks to the sidelines for a little more direction. Hardaway clears the former play, and we add another play to it. Dakota Rose to his right. Great catch.
I believe that's a first down.
Another
right
good
there.
Catch.
Kanan
out in the flat.
Hauled in another
there.
One.
Kanan Taylor on the reception. Elias Carter will take those 5 or 6 8-yard catches every time.
Oh, yeah.
First and 10. Obviously, no huddle. Kind of, it's not necessarily, we don't necessarily run a hurry up. We just kind of hurry up and get to the line and then take some time after that.
Methodically get our play out there.
Yes, sir. First and 10.
Quarterback keeper.
Oh, my thigh. Good tackle there.
Yep.
We'll take 3 or so and keep that clock running. Second down and 7 for your Dardanelle Sand Lizards. Ball's placed at about the 26 and a half yard line. Lies, we got trips to the left. single receiver to the right. Elias decides to take it one more time. And up the middle he goes.
Got a big hole.
Nobody's going to catch him. That's a touchdown. Right up the gut.
Well, I'll tell you what, I believe we could have drove a school bus that, up there.
Right up the gut. Yes, sir.
And that's like what I've been telling you. We've been hammering them right up the middle.
Timo coming in to we bring in some fresh bodies for the line to give some of our linemen some breather. Bring in a couple different ones. I think Dalton Dillon might be in there. Some other high snap. Ball's kicked.
Good high kick.
Is up. 6:40 left to go in the third quarter. Dardanelle St. Lizards 34, Paris 7. Got some scores.
You missed it by one.
Oh, I'm sorry, 35. I looked at the scoreboard too quick. Got some scores here to pass along just around the state. Mountain Home, 24. Nettleton, 21 in the third quarter. Dover, 42. Two Rivers, 0 in the third quarter. Third quarter also, Cabot, 14. El Dorado, 7. Also in the second quarter, Nashville, 40. DeQueen, 0. Pea Ridge, up on Green Forest, 52-6. Smackover, 21, Harding Academy, 0. Atkins, 13, Bigelow, 8. Danville, 21, Lavaca, 7. Center Point, 28, Magnet Cove, 0. Robinson, 35, CAC, 14. Ball's on the tee. Timo approaches the ball.
That's a good kick right there. Dropped her back in the end zone.
And we'll take it. That'll be a touchback for Timo.
You know, we need us a fumble recovery right here. Interception wouldn't hurt my feelings.
Here's another one of our soon-to-be conference opponents. Elkins is leading West Fork. West Fork will be down the road here in a few weeks.
Did you see the Boonville score?
Elkins 49, West Fork 6.
Boonville 13, Gravett 0.
Oh. First and 10 at the 20-yard line for Paris.
That's a good play right there, boy. That's what we need more of.
Great play there.
Backfield. Chase Hickey got in there to him.
Chase Hickey, Brock Finkenbinder. Looked like Shark in there on the tackle, maybe.
Shark was in there.
Be a second and about 11, maybe 12, maybe a long 11. Paris goes twins on both on the wide side. They bring four in motion. And quarterback, I wish he had given that one away,
yes,
maybe.
Yes, sir, I believe he does.
He sticks it in there for a couple of yards, maybe, back up to about the original line of scrimmage, back up to, matter of fact, the ball is just over the 20-yard line. Paris has it third and about nine, a long nine, probably closer to 10 if it was measured. Paris looking to the sidelines for coach's information. And the dude holding the beautiful sign is asleep now, so he's not even holding the sign up.
It's on the ground.
No, it's not going to. Quarterback drops. Get him, Shark. Wrap up and make a tackle. Or drag him out of bounds. That'll work. Be fourth down for Paris. Looks like probably fourth and maybe a long two.
Yep.
See what Paris does right here. I can't hardly see where they would. Of course, I guess they're what, two for two?
Yep. See if we can shut them down right here.
I'm looking for something in the flats. Elias is about 10 yards off. There we go.
Little quick kick there.
Peter. Pretty good Paris roll there, but we'll take that as a punt. And we'll take that. Dardanelle will take over possession at the 5:15 mark, leading 35-7. It'll be first and 10 at about the 33 of Dardanelle. Pretty good defensive possession there.
That one was good. I'll take that one. And did you see that Waldron is up on Cedarville at halftime, 21-14?
I knew they would be. I had a wise gentleman talk to me this week about Waldron, and you know, that coach came from Boonville.
Yes, he did.
And you know, they don't lose a whole lot in Boonville.
No, they don't.
I know they were down last year, but they don't. They're not. Their tradition's to win, and he's taking that to Waldron, and they are. Oof.
I believe I'm going to have to talk to somebody about missing block on that.
That one didn't go much right there.
No, sure it did not.
He might have been asleep there. Ozark's leading Clarksville 28-0. Clinton's up 34-0 on Berryville.
Dakota got about five, maybe.
You know, Waldron hadn't won a game since 11, if I'm not mistaken.
Well, that sounds and, about right.
They're fixing to be on a two-game winning streak, be 2-0.
Did you see a Stuttgart score in there anywhere?
I did not, and that's what I was looking for, to be honest with you. Be 3rd and 8 for the Sand Lizards. Ball's on the 35. Lies flanked with Twins on the right.
Oh, there you go. Way to hang on to that ball,
Tate. Run, Tater Tot. That'll be enough for a first down. Good catch and fetch there. Great concentration by Tate as he juggled it.
That almost looked like his dad.
Well, he caught it, though.
You got a point. I don't believe Ed would have brought that one home. Or.
Ed's head would have been in the way. But Tate made a good catch there and stumbled and bumbled.
That there, if Ed would have been trying to catch that ball.
Tate stumbled and his way for a first down. Good play there. 1st and 10.
Quarterback keeper got a pretty good hole right there. Look at there. Going up the pipe there. Still going.
Oh! Nice job there by Jose Perez coming back and trying to help free the quarterback there. There ain't nothing about that but just a straight-ahead quarterback dive, just to be perfectly honest with you. He faked Dakota, and he just countered it. Matter of fact, I don't even know if he counted it. I think he just went right with him.
Yeah, it looked like just a right up the pipe.
Be 1st and 10 for the Lizards.
And looks like we got another one, another good hole right there.
Bring up 2nd down and probably about 4, maybe. Looks like, yes, maybe a long 4. Ball's just outside the 20 of Paris. Ball's placed about the nose, is about the 21-yard line. Football, so that's going to be close to a first down, Russell. What do you think? What do you see?
Well, I'm looking here. I'm looking over at that. We got about 3rd and 1 foot, looks like. Well, I tell you what, we got a bunch of Carters over there holding them chains on that other side. That's going to be close. I think he'll have it.
Dakota with the dive, and I'm going to say he needed one, and I think he got about about a one and
wide
and a little bit.
Signal them to move the chains.
First and 10, just inside the 20.
Oh!
Ran a good route, put a good ball in there.
Hit him right in the hands.
Hit him right in the bad spot. But that'll put a 2nd and 10. Ball's at the 17-yard line. Offense looking at the sidelines to Coach Hardaway for the play. Lass comes up to the line, barks some instruction, moves Tate to the other side of the football. And here we go.
Oh, that guy come through the backside.
He pulled right with him, and nobody filled where they left. I'm going to say somebody's supposed to scoop down on that one, and nobody scooped and got him. 220, 218, 216 left to go in the 2nd quarter. Changing out some personnel. Receivers coming off the field, some new receivers coming on. 3rd and 10, it looks like, Russell.
Yep. Got to see what we got dialed up for this one right here. Dropping back to pass. Low, wide open. Oh, in and out of the hands of Kyle Smith. That would have been pay dirt if he could have hung on to that one.
And I'll be honest with you, it looked like if he might have stayed on his feet.
He might have had a better chance of catching it.
He might have ran under that one. But good effort. Can't fault the effort. He made a dive.
It was there.
Elias put a pretty good spin on the ball. We're going lined up for a field goal here. Ball's going to be put down at about the 25. Snaps up. Kicks up.
Looks good.
And we're going to say that'd be good.
It is good.
And we'll take it. 1:50 left to go in the third quarter at Sand Lizard Stadium. Bob Keenan Field and Tyson Track.
What's the score?
It'd be 38-7.
38-7.
That score is sponsored by Terry Thone. Arkadelphia 28, Sheridan 28, P. Ridge 52, Green Forest 6. Charleston Tigers 42, Little Rock Episcopal 12.
Team on our tennis will be kicking for Sand Lizard. The deep men on the forward to Kobe and Wise, number 9, Nate Davidson, and number 23, Justin Williams.
Timo approaches the football.
Good kick. That one's
that hit
zone.
The back line of the end zone, if I'm not mistaken.
That was awful Zach Hawkerish right there.
We'll take that one all day long. Once again, as I said a while ago, a Razorback would look good on that helmet instead of a number. But anyway, Paris will take over at the 20-yard line after a touchback. Once again, in shotgun formation, twins on either side. They brought number 4 in motion about 90% of the night, and we'll see what they'll do here.
Looks like at halftime, Stuttgart is getting beat by Warren, 7-0. A little screen pass right there.
It's good for about 3, it looks like, maybe.
Yeah.
Maybe 4. Yeah, it looks like about
4. We closed in on that one a little bit better.
What'd you say the score was?
It looks like Warren 7, Stuttgart 0 at halftime.
Talked to Coach Price a couple of times this week, and you know exactly what Nashville's got. They're loaded, just like Warren, just like always. Paris has a ball, second and about 7. They bring 4 in motion, and here he comes.
They did a good job of stringing that one out.
Nine and 4 is going to be tired. They've ran from side to side.
Yep.
Lots.
They're running a lot of east and west.
Bring up third down
and
about
south on this field.
That's right. Be third down and about 4, maybe a long 4.
Well, I believe the card
the sign,
man
the
is
sign worker's
up
again.
Yep.
Took him a little nap, a little
power eye.
Ball's on the ground, and we're going to have a false start, I believe. I'd a lot rather had the ball, but anyway.
Yes,
there is laundry on the field. Well, that's what we're going to have.
Offsides on the
defense. Yeah. I'll give them 5 yards for Paris. That'll pick them up a first down. Ball's just over the 30-yard line. Of Paris, ball will be about the 31-yard line as the official literally kicks the ball all the way out to the place of placing the ball. First and 10 for the Paris Eagles. Pistol formation.
Dropping back to pass. He had a little pressure put on him there. Throwing it back cross field.
You know what I saw right there? I saw 2 people hit him and nobody wrap him up.
Yep.
And he tripped and fell.
Yes, sir. Well, I'm kind of glad he threw it to the running back because we had one wide open
streaking down
here in
the
middle
field.
Of the field.
Yes, sir. Sure did. Brings up second and 4 for Paris Eagles.
quarterback keeper. He fooled everybody right there.
I'll be honest with you, that got me too.
Preston Drury on the carry. Cannon Taylor makes the tackle.
Be enough for a first down. Paris moving the football just over the 40-yard line, their own 40-yard line. I think we got, I think Nine's cramping maybe or something.
He's down.
Actually, he's, I don't know what he's doing.
He may have got the breath knocked out of him.
I think he does.
Seen him patting his chest there. I hope that's what it is.
We're going to give you a little band.
Injured player was number nine, Nate Davidson for Paris. They're escorting him off the field. He's still getting off slow. I don't know if he had the breath knocked out of him or what happened.
I really don't have a clue what was going on. He kind of tapped himself out and then just kind of went down there. And
I didn't really see what happened to him. First and 10, Paris with 6 seconds left in the third quarter.
We need to stop this drive right here. They got I formation. H-back is on the right side here.
I believe they're going to call a timeout.
No, they're going to let the quarter end.
Yep, sure did.
End of the third quarter, we're holding right now, sound major 38, Paris leader.
And that'll be the end of the third quarter, where your Dardanelle Sand Lizards are 38, Paris Eagles 7.
Well, J.D., we got 12 minutes left here. Still looking pretty good for us.
We are, and
but we can't let up.
Cannot. I mean, without anything, cannot let up here. Lots of things could happen in 12 minutes.
Yes, sir. I believe it's scoreboard out there shows 84 degrees this Friday night, September 9th, 2016.
It wouldn't hurt my feelings at all if this is the last 80
last
plus
heat
degrees
wave.
That
I guarantee
we have
you. I'm ready for some fat man weather myself.
Oh, that's right up my alley.
Well, we flipped the field here.
Paris will have it first and 10 on their own 46-yard line. Surveys the field.
Quarterback, keeper.
That's pretty successful when the backside end's chasing the guy without
yep.
the football.
That's right.
Quarterback keeps for about 4 yards. There'll be second down and a long six for the Paris Eagles. Ball's placed right on that red and white 50-yard line. Got trips right for the quarterback. Running back flanked to his right. They bring 23 in motion.
Looks almost like the same play. Oh, boy. We cannot let that happen, JD. He got behind both of our guys.
Guess what? Again. And I know we've done a pretty good job with that tonight, but
yep.
They haven't thrown it deep a whole lot either. But, man, we have blown coverage. I don't know if we were got caught up in wanting to rest or what, but we cannot.
Well, that play looked just like the last one, except that time the quarterback didn't keep it and run. He threw it out there. Looks like the same thing. Oh, low ball on the ground, and I believe we got it.
Oh, Finky. No, Brock, that was Curris.
Yeah, Nick Curris on the fumble recovery.
Your Sand Lizards will take over on the Paris 45-yard line with 11:18 left to go in the game. Dardanelle 38, Paris 7.
Hardaway.
What's that, about four takeaways tonight?
I believe so. I believe you're right. I know had one interception, and I believe that was the third fumble recovery we got right there.
Yes, sir.
Back to pass. I don't know where that one was going there.
Well, I think somebody hit it.
Did they get a hand on it?
I think somebody hit it. It might not have, but I think they did. Be second and 10. We'll be able to see it in just a second right here on this replay.
Yep.
Surveying the field, bringing some people in and out, and some people that went in came back out. And be second and 10, balls at the 45 of Paris. Brings Tate in motion.
Quarterback keeper's got big. Looky there. Oh, and we got a flag on the field. That was a late flag. And I don't know what it was. Looks like it's against us. What'd he say, holding?
Personal foul.
Personal foul. Well, I'm going to have to watch this and hear on our playback.
That'll push us way back. Second about 20. Well, second about 17, maybe. Directing some people around.
Little option play here. Pitch out to Dakota Rowland. Still on his feet there.
Good hard run. Good option, good read, good pitch. Third and about 8 for the Lizards. Ball's back at about the 43-yard line of Paris. Clock clock's ticking. About 10 minutes left to go in the fourth quarter.
On the carry is the last quarter.
That one went absolutely nowhere.
Yeah, it went for about nothing. Be fourth and about, well, might even give us a yard. Maybe gave us forward progress, maybe. Looks like we're going to have to punt the ball. Be fourth and eight. Ball's placed at about the 43. Ball will be teed up or on the tee at about the 49-yard line. They got a kid deep, number four. And Boggles in the end zone. Paris takes over at the 20-yard line, at their own 20-yard line. Be first and 10, 9:26 left to go in the fourth quarter.
Well, we need another good stand right here.
Be first and 10. Paris doing some shuffling around on offense here. Play clock winding down, 2 seconds left.
Quarterback running around like a chicken with his head cut off and still going.
That was not. That was a busted play,
yes,
I believe.
Yes, sir, he gained about 15 yards.
That turned out to be a positive play. Now, that happens a lot, you know.
Well, we have got to keep a composure here.
9:16 left to go in the fourth quarter. Clock's hopefully rolling. Clock's hopefully rolling, but it's not. There it goes. Quarterback single back. Ball's on the ground again.
And I believe nobody's there, and I don't think he was out of the tackle box.
Oh, he's going to say that kid was in the area. Yeah, he was in the area if you count 30 yards down
the
field.
Yeah.
He was there the time the ball rolled about 5 or so yards.
Well,
and came
I cannot
back.
Believe that he did not call that intentional grounding.
That'll be second and 10 for the Paris Eagles. They need to strike quick if they're going to get something going here. Quarterback's moving some people around. Got Trips to his right. And whistle blows.
Looks like we had a little heat coming in there on the right side.
Time out. Time out for Paris. Time out for the Paris Eagles.
J.D., I've had some questions. People have been asking me if we're going to be able to archive these.
We are working on that as we speak.
All right.
And hopefully you'll be able to pull it off of our website. That's what we're hoping.
Okay.
There'll be links on the website, and you'll be able to pull those off of our website. So I really don't think it's necessarily for the ball game that they're wanting. I think they're wanting it for –
They just want to hear us. That's what I gather.
For comic relief. But anyway, we're our technology department, John Nathan George and Drew Laughinghouse, are working on that to help us get that going. We will be right back here next Friday evening at 7 o'clock game time. 7 o'clock game time, and about 6:50 as far as a little pregame show, and live streaming will start about 6:30. We'll follow the band in and stay with the band for pregame and all those type activities. And have a good evening next Friday night when Clarksville Panthers roll into town. It's second and 10 at the 35. He is under
got pressure on the quarterback. Oh, falls incomplete.
That'd be incomplete.
Nick Curtis put a little hit on the quarterback as he got rid of the ball.
He came in heavy on him. Be third and 10. Ball still at the 35-yard line. Clock has stopped. I don't necessarily like that, but anyway, clock has stopped. Be third and 10. They change out some players on offense. Going to go trips to the quarterback's right. Running back to his left. Single receiver out wide on the right side.
It's like we got a little heat on him. Got that one. Oh! I think that pressure made that a little bit high there.
Yes, it did. Shark in that fancy face mask.
Yeah, boy. Looks like he's going to try to set a little tunnel screen up out here on their left side of the line of scrimmage.
Be fourth and 10.
I believe, don't know, looks like they may pooch kick it again.
Quarterback is also.
Oh, we got movement there. They're going to back it up another five.
Finke's pointing fingers. Yep. He's hoping it's them. And we're going to be backed up about five more, looks like. So it's going to be about fourth and 15 for Paris. About 8:50 left to go in the fourth quarter.
Now, if that doesn't make them punt, I don't know what will.
I don't know.
Fourth and a country mile.
I'm afraid I spoke way too early on the that was a quick quarter.
Yes, sir.
First quarter went real quick, and from there it's been downhill as far as time goes. But it is a quick kick, and we're going to get out of the way.
Give us a 49.
Well, your Sand Lizards take over first and 10, right at about the 50-yard line, about the 49 of Dardanelle.
We'll take over. That wasn't happy that spotted the ball for us either that time.
No, it wasn't. Band's back up and going for the fourth quarter. Cheerleaders cheering, and stands are still pretty full. We've had a few leave, but for the most part, still pretty full.
Paris's sideline over there, their stands have been a little quiet tonight.
They have. I won't argue or gripe about that. So, first and 10, Elias looks back to the sidelines.
Quarterback keeper. He's still going to end up getting about five or six.
Good job. Nice job with Cody Rowland peeled back and
picked up that,
I think that
backside
was
end coming through there, I believe.
Second and six for your Sand Lizards as we're letting that play clock run.
Still on his feet there.
Great second effort there.
Yes, sir.
Really good second effort. They had him for a loss, not for a loss, but had him for a small gain, and he ended up gaining about three or four more after contact. We're pulling well, but I'm telling you, we're getting chased down from the backside by the people who we're leaving from. That play side's got to scoop that direction and get those guys.
Well, if we could run a little pitch off that going against the grain there on something like that, that might, the way they're pursuing that ball right down the line, when them two linemen pull, they're just crashing right down with them.
Third and one. I don't believe we got it. Be fourth and one. We're bringing heavy package back in. I bet you we're going to run the football. Official blows the play ready.
Oh, had a good surge from the line, and he still ain't on the ground yet.
That'll
and
be
we got another flag down.
There is a flag on the play.
How are they going to call a hold when everybody was laying on the ground? Holding on us.
I'm afraid he's going to call that on Tate Vestal. That's where he threw it in that direction.
Well, let's look at the replay and here Tate, and see what we get.
Tate didn't do anything. Watch him right here. I don't know.
I didn't see it there.
Honestly, I didn't see anything. Unless he caught it on Hardaway's talking to 45 there, so he might. I mean, I don't know. I didn't see anything. But anyway.
Wonder if he's going to angle this one out or what's he going to do on this one? Yep, I believe they're going to angle the ball a little bit. They better hurry. We got about 10 seconds on the play clock. Stop right there. Looky there. Looky there. Oh, yeah. Inside the five.
Good hustle there by Shark. It's because of that face mask.
That's aerodynamics. Got him down there quicker.
Got him right down there. Got to protect those teeth because
yes,
he smiles
sir.
All the time.
That's right. Protect them pearly whites.
Paris takes over first and 10 just inside their own five. Looks like about the four-yard line where Paris takes over. 6:21 left to go in the game. Sand Lizard still up 38-7. That score was sponsored by Terry Thone. And a power eye here.
Oh, there's a missed tackle.
Arm.
We had tackle. Him back there at about the one, I believe.
Arm.
Brock didn't tackle. Wrap him up that time.
Arm tackle. Got a breakdown and make a play. Be second and about two for Paris. Ball's at about the 13. Back in the power eye.
Hand off to the first back through, and I tell you what, Tate Vestal made him like a Mack truck.
Chase Hickey had him held up, and Tate obliged him by knocking him on backwards.
Yep.
Just a straight old fullback dive for a first down. Paris has the ball first and 10, just over their 15-yard line. Quarterback back in a power eye. That kind of surprises me, to be honest with you.
Yep, handoff. Oh!
Oh,
I believe that's number 63. Caden Brown come through there and mopped it up.
Low. Holy smoke. That was pretty nice right there.
I taught him that one. Yes, sir.
Look like he's hugging
his
mama.
What I do at the
right
house,
there.
I hold a biscuit up.
Do you?
Yeah, we've got a little daub it in some gravy, yeah. Son. Here he comes.
Training.
Yes, sir.
Kind of like a tackling dummy.
Yeah, just like you do an old bird dog.
I have absolutely no idea what that play was at all.
Lyman had the ball, ended up with. I don't know if it was a bad snap.
I think he snapped it to himself.
Oh, we got a flag there. It's an illegal procedure. I believe they're going to be back about the same spot they were when they started this drive out.
I have a shout-out, speaking of Caden, but anyway, his young lady friend, Ashton Sitkowski, they are she's playing for Hendricks Volleyball. They are down in Texas, I believe.
Sherman, Texas.
Playing, and I'm sure if she's able to, she's listening or watching. So play hard, and good luck to you guys. And we're cheering somewhat hard for you.
Boy, look at there. Oh, we almost had him back there. He tippy-toed out of bounds.
You know, and I hate to be negative, but some of our issue as far as coming in position to tackle is about angles.
Yes.
And we're not taking real good angles, but some of that's just – and I hate to use young and inexperienced, but some of it's just because I hadn't played football in a while.
That's right.
So we're hoping after a few more games or a few more practices that we'll take better pursuit angles.
Got the spread.
Got trips right for the quarterback.
Well,
Boy, better hope he gets down in a hurry because they're chasing him.
Yep.
Quarterback has been wore out. Be fourth and about nine, it looks like, Russell, for Paris.
Yep.
And we're going to have a bringing their punt team. And
see if we can get in here and get us a block on this one. We got Kane and Taylor.
I don't know.
I'm going to say that was a procedure.
I don't know if the
I don't think he ever snapped the ball. Boy, I'd like to see us bring a house on this one, block that rascal.
I'd take another six or seven.
You know, Caden got him a block punt last week. Had
yes, sir.
Wearing a bruise on his arm right here. It looked like a football, boy. He's ugly. Oh, and we got a piece of it.
Still gets a pretty good Paris roll. Ball's going to be down about the 35-yard line. .338 left to go in the game. Your Sand Lizards 38. Paris 7. Don't forget Basketball Booster Club, October the 1st fishing tournament out at Lake Dardanelle State Park. For more information, contact Coach Sturnevant or April Metcalf, who's the president of the Basketball Boosters, for more information. October the 1st, Basketball Booster Fishing Tournament. October 1st at Lake Dardanelle State Park. Dardanelle takes over first and 10. The ball's placed in shotgun formation. He's flanked with Trips on his left side. He brings Kanan Taylor in motion, and he's going to let him come all the way over.
Looks like we've got a little option. Oh, out there, he's got some room, got some green grass. I believe he's going to score a touchdown.
And that will be a touchdown. Great, great read, great pitch, great outside there. That might have been, I want to say that might have been David Fraley out there with a good block out of the receiver.
He did good out there. Boy, and I'm telling you what, son, there was real estate.
There was a lot of ground out there, and we did a great job. And we'll take six there. Timo Martinez in for the extra point. I never get tired of hearing the fight song.
No, I don't.
Because that usually means something positive.
That's right.
Kicks up.
Believe it's good.
And good.
Went right over that Tyson Limblum down there on the high jump area.
3:28 left to go in the fourth quarter. Dardanelle Sand Lizards 45, Paris 7. We'll be back in just a minute.
The deep men, number 4, Jacobin Wise, number 9, Nate Davidson, number 23, Justice Lee.
2:55, 2:50, we had the mercy rule invoked. Clock's going to run. It's going to get a much quicker here in the next 2.5 minutes.
Last 2-3 minutes will go pretty fast, boy. Another good boom, popped her in the end zone.
And
I just like to say that it wouldn't hurt my feelings to see him do that every kickoff.
Yes, sir. And we've got some of our former players. I know Parker Witt down at OBU. I think they're traveling over to Durant, Oklahoma, maybe Southeast Oklahoma State.
Yes,
they're playing tomorrow. Christian Thompson, they're headed out in Oklahoma as well, and I cannot remember.
I asked
his mama. I asked Carrie.
Northwestern?
I asked Kerry this afternoon, and I might be. I don't remember. It's somewhere out in Oklahoma.
It's either Alva. I think it may be Alva.
So wish them a best of luck.
They're going to be in the flat country. I know that much.
It'll be real flat. So wish both of them the best of luck. And Christian, obviously, Wonder Boys, and Parker as OBU Tiger. Chris Kirshner is playing for Navy, as we all know. They play all their freshmen at a prep type college or prep type setting as a freshman.
Okay.
So they basically redshirt. Number 15 would be Chris Kirshner.
Okay.
And he's up to about 205, I believe.
Wow.
Tad over 6 foot, and I'm telling you, he looks like a beast.
Wow.
And he's getting to play. Played some last week.
We have a fresh unit of defense out there on the field right now for Dardanelle. Fumble. I'm going to tell you, J.D., I'm glad he fumbled that, because they had a receiver over on the far sideline that nobody was on.
Yes, sir, because I believe Cody Howe forgot that he had a receiver out there.
Yes, sir.
But anyway, we're good to go here. 208 and ticking. You ask and you shall receive, or you talk and you shall get an answer. But Miss Carrie Figueroa, Christians.
Good tackle by Fraley.
Christian's mom texted me and said that they are they're at Oklahoma Baptist in Shawnee tomorrow.
Oh, okay. So, that's not as bad of a drive. It's still flat, but out there in tornado country.
That's right. Also, listening to us down there in Texas, Miss Tammy Gentry is down with Ashton's mom, Taryn, down in Texas.
Big town, I believe it's in Sherman, Texas.
So, hey, you and I, we're kind of food experts.
Yes,
sir. And
there's
a place down there called Cackle and Oink. Brother.
Hey, now, that sounds my kind of, sounds like my kind of place right there now.
Lots of barbecue.
Oh, wrap good up, backside son. Tackle.
Good job there.
Number 90.
That one of the, that's one of the Perfecto boys, I bet you.
Eduardo
Perfecto.
He came up around the backside and hung on to him.
Clock's ticking. 47, 45 seconds. It'll be a third and about several days.
Yes, sir.
Clock's moving. Mr. Thompson's got a piece of cake on the road, and Mr. L, I don't see anything in Mr. L's. He's got a phone. He don't have any food. He's leaving out.
Good game,
folks. That's
right,
going to be about all.
I believe that's going to be all she wrote.
As the band cranks up, and we'll let you listen to it.
Piping up.
Clock's ticking at about 17. And if I was Paris' quarterback, I'd say, Coach, if you want to snap, you come take it yourself,
son. That's right. We got everybody wadding up down here on the 50. I don't think they're going to snap the ball. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. There's your horn right there. That's the ball game.
And that'll be the ball game. Your Dardanelle Sand Lizards 45. Paris Eagles 7 on the second week of high school football of September. Good night for the Sand Lizards. It's been a great night for the Sand Lizards. Good night
That's
for football.
Right.
And the Sand Lizards came out after a little stumble on our first series
and
never looked back after that.
After that, they just kept pounding the ball. We mixing it up a little bit, passing, a little bit of running. We was doing good running that ball right up the middle.
Capitalized on multiple turnovers and took advantage of it. We talked about in the pregame show that once we get inside that 20 or even over the 50, we had to capitalize and do something positive.
And we actually did pretty good. I don't think we had a drive stall out on us once tonight.
And I'm going to say we did the job tonight. And
yes, we did.
I'm very thankful for that.
There's still some things we can take away to learn from. And, like I say, we got a young team.
Defense, I thought the defense for the most part, we had some letdown as far as some tackles again, but we had some kids in position, and we'll take a win.
That's right. A W is a W, any way you look at it.
I do have one last shout-out. Coach McCoy's done the filming for us last couple of games, and he'll pick it back up for us again. Tony Apples, filming for us, who's been our production guy and our producer, I guess
That's
you'd
right.
say. But Coach McCoy is with his mama, who is not doing well health-wise, and it's in Little Rock. So we're going to say a special prayer
Prayers
for him.
Prayers go out to her.
And him and his family as they deal with this, and we wish the best for them. And next Friday night, same place, Same time.
Now, if I'm not mistaken, you're not going to be, you'll be absent.
I will be absent. I have the luxury of having to go to a wedding next Friday night, so I will not be here, but Taylor Kendrick will fill in next week. He'll be professional.
That's right.
Professional Taylor Kendrick.
I'm going to have to straighten up a little bit next week, boy.
For Mr. Apple on the video, for Russell Brown here providing some comic relief and color, I am John David Keeling, and this has been Lizard Live. Hope you've enjoyed it. If you have, give us a shout-out and continue to promote us on Facebook and other places. And for now, farewell, good night, God bless, have a great weekend. Go Lizards.